Alright, this is Christopher Foss once again, and this is a request this time for Lisa. And the name of this video is Top 10 Most Heartbreaking 13 Reasons Why Moments Season 1. Ooh, this is gonna get real fucked up, man, and sad, so let's check it out.
We thought one box of tissues was going to be enough. We were wrong. Welcome to Ms. Mojo, and today we're counting down our
that's a good show, though.
Heartbreaking moments in 13 Reasons Why.
Because that's the kind of school that this is. Everyone is just so nice until they drive you to kill yourself. And sooner or later, the truth will come out.
Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. For this list, we'll be looking at the first season of the show, and at all the moments that left us in tears and or filled with emotion. Whether the moment had us angry, hurt, frustrated, or crying our eyes out, it's eligible.
I can't tell you what it is. And I don't want you to know, because I don't want you to look at me that way. And it would kill me if you heard what were on those tapes.
Number 10, plays flashback.
You don't want to be with me, Clay.
But I do. I really do.
You know what people will say?
No.
Clay knows deep down that if he'd done or said something differently, Hannah might still be alive. It's a painful truth that has been tearing him apart for the whole duration of the show, as he tries desperately to understand all the reasons that Hannah chose to kill herself.
I was an asshole.
I hate those words.
And I'm sorry.
I hate those words. Kill yourself. I hate those fucking words.
And I can never make it right. I can never say all this to you, but I love you.
In the 11th episode, guilt and sadness overwhelm him, and he has a flashback to a time with Hannah. Rather than just reliving the moment, he takes it as an opportunity to do what he failed to do when she was alive. Unfortunately, there's no going back, as Hannah reminds him when she delivers a line that causes both Clay and the viewers to crumble.
I love you, Hannah.
Why didn't you say this to me when I was alive?
Jesus Christ.
Number 9. Clay and Hannah at the dance.
Oh, man.
Okay. Go get her and do what? It's a dance, right? Maybe dance with her? I can't dance.
This moment is not only beautiful and touching, but also a taste of what could have been. It's a hard scene to watch as well, as we know it will never be.
You look adorable.
There's that word again.
I didn't know you were here.
Yeah, I get that a lot. Like when?
A skill I wish I had.
Mistakes caused by a lot of people result in the loss of an innocent girl's life. And in the wake of this tragedy, the life of everyone involved was changed forever. At the dance, Clay and Hannah talk and laugh and have a good time, finding out a bit more about each other in the process.
You lied to me.
What?
You said you had no rhythm. You dance like a pro.
Sadly, their moment together quickly gets derailed.
I should go take care of her.
Yeah, for sure.
In hindsight, all Clay can do is imagine the kiss that could have been. Number 8.
That's messed.
Clay talking to Jeff's parents.
There's something you should know about the night of the accident.
Jeff, you left us too soon. Towards the end of the show, more and more pieces of the puzzle get revealed, and thus, Jeff's parents find out what really happened the night of the crash. Jeff was a fan favorite, one of the truly good ones in the show. And it's heartbreaking to watch his parents realize that their son wasn't the one at fault in the accident that took his life.
I was there. I saw him just before he left. And I don't think he was drunk.
Wow.
You know?
They're able to hold on to the fact that their son was always trying to do the right thing, and take some measure of comfort knowing that extenuating circumstances contributed to the crash.
It wasn't Jeff's fault. The stop sign on the corner had already been knocked down earlier in the night.
Rest in peace, Jeff. You'll be missed. Number 7, Hannah leaving the store.
Hey, Wally.
Oh, hey.
Being put on the list was terrible enough, but dealing with the repercussions of it was worse. All Hannah wanted to do was get some chocolate, but it seems like wherever she goes, assault follows her. Bryce, easily one of the worst people of the show, decides to take advantage of her in the store, sexually assaulting her.
Bryce can go suck an egg. Chris Frost, put that down. I'll get age restricted again.
It's just, it's real tight.
Put that down.
In the store. It's tight in the store.
The horror and disbelief on Hannah's face matched our own. Seeing Hannah try to process the emotions that accompanied this violation as she leaves the store is not
Hannah really should beat the fuck out of that fucking asshole.
Blood boil.
It seems like nothing. Until the hurricane hits. Because when you put my name on that list, you put a target on my... Well, it wasn't just my ass.
Number 6. Clay and Tony climbing to the top of the mountain.
We're getting closer. Just remember you gotta go slow. If you want to climb fast.
We go from an exhilarating and exciting moment to one of sadness and despair.
To be honest, we only need 2 seasons. The third and fourth one weren't that good.
Is a doozy.
She walks up to the door. She leaves this box. And goes. I didn't get up.
For the first time, we get some insight into the night Hannah died and how Tony played into it. He knows he made a mistake by not opening the door for Hannah and, adding to his pain, he acted just late enough to witness her body being taken away.
And they just grabbed the bag and threw her in the ambulance. Just like that.
One can't begin to fathom the guilt he must have been living with since her death, or the weight of having been so close to stopping her. Number 5, Clay listening to his tape.
Your name does not belong on this list. But you need to be here if I'm going to tell my story.
It's the moment he'd been dreading. Who would want to listen to their own tape anyway? Well, he does. And in that moment, all Clay's feelings of guilt, anger, sadness, and confusion peak simultaneously.
You're different. You're good and kind and decent.
I can barely see what's going on.
And I don't deserve to be with someone like you.
His breakdown is like a release for the audience, too, bringing us all to tears right alongside Clay. It was a relief to hear that he was unlike the others on the tape, but it was still heartbreaking to watch him come to terms with the fact that, in his case, action rather than inaction could have prevented Hannah's death.
And I knew I shouldn't have left, and then Bryce raped Jessica, and Hannah saw, and then Sherry knocked down the stop sign, and then Jess died, and it all started with me!
Number 4. Clay talking to Mr. Porter.
Hannah Baker came to see you the day she died.
School counselors hold a tremendous responsibility for their students' well-being. They're relied upon when a student is going through a time of hurt, and their inability to act accordingly can have grave consequences.
And you could have stopped it. And I could have. Justin Foley could have. And a dozen other people, at least. But we didn't.
In a twist, we find out that Mr. Porter is the 13th reason why. He had a lot of chances to turn things around, and the signs were there from the start, but never did. As Clay tells him of this, we can't help but feel bad for him. He was a guy who made mistakes, and now he has to live with them for the rest of his life.
And everyone who comes before you on these tapes knows what you did and didn't do.
Yeah.
They always will.
Number 3, Jessica Davis talking to her dad about being a rape survivor.
You okay?
Ordinary dish soap.
You don't look fine.
Acknowledging something as painful as sexual assault can be excruciating, but it's also essential to processing the trauma.
She said things happened.
If something happened, I'd remember it.
As we've been learning throughout the series, Bryce is not a good person, and an atrocious
party
cements his monster status. Jessica refuses to believe it, even though she knows deep down it's the truth. Finally, she breaks down to her father after he notices she hasn't been the same recently. Seeing her do this not only makes it real for her, but for the audience too.
Yeah.
Something happened to me.
Suffice it to say, we eagerly await for Bryce's comeuppance. Number 2. Hannah's rape.
Her.
I can't believe Hannah Baker finally came to one of my parties.
Why would you?
Just when we thought it couldn't get any worse, this happens. Bryce has been a bully, nuisance, confirmed rapist, and overall.
She should have beat the fuck out of him.
This moment just makes the audience's blood collectively boil even more.
Sorry, I gotta go.
Oh god.
With Hannah suffering from crippling depression at this point, She just didn't care where she walked and where she ended up. She ended up at Bryce's, and sadly, he took advantage of her and the situation, as he's been known to do. Upon learning of this, Clay confronts Bryce, just like the whole audience of the show would if they could.
Did you rape Hannah Baker?
Number one, Hannah's parents finding her dead in the bathroom.
Yeah, that is to be number one.
No matter what we may
they better not show anything, though.
Hear about it on the news, we will never begin to understand the pain of what it feels like for a parent to lose their child. The actors portraying Hannah's
and these were kids.
Did a remarkable job.
These weren't the complex adults
associated with Hannah's death.
No. Come on, honey. It's okay. Come on, baby.
We knew the moment was coming, and yet we wished that it would somehow end differently.
She's okay. Call 911.
Watching the culmination of all the pain Hannah endured up until she felt like suicide was the only choice tore us to pieces
and
left a lasting impression on viewers everywhere.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from Myth.
Yeah, it's probably one of the most hardest scenes to watch I've ever witnessed. I mean, the fact that they were able to film that and get away with the... I'm not even sure what the show is rated. It's probably like MA or something. I mean, it's... The scene was cut on the, on Netflix, but I got it on DVD, and the whole scene is fucking there. Well, you watch morbid stuff, you watch scary movies, but that shit ain't like real shit like this. 13 Reasons Why is a realistic show. Shit like a horror movie of any shape or form isn't fucking real. This shit is real. Okay? Plain and simple. But, yeah. I might go eat and then make one more video and then eat. I'm not sure. So yeah. So with that said, guys, thanks for watching. Take care. What do you think of 13 Reasons Why? I think it's a great show. It's sad. It's depressing, but it's a good show. At least the first two seasons. But yeah. Thanks for watching. Take care. See you on the next one. Peace out.